I mentioned last night that the new definition of friend back in summer of 94 was a true friend is someone who walks in when someone else walks out. And that's what Christ does. He walks in and he won't leave. And he says, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'm right here. You can try to outrun me, but there's nowhere you can go where I'm not right here. Well, back in that same year, in that same summer, the winning definition for the word love was given. It's a very biblical definition. Love. Giving somebody what they need, not necessarily what they want. You know what you're in need of today? You're in need of the realization, if you're a believer today, that you are forgiven. And you're missing out on fellowship with the one who created sunsets and surfing and seafood and sex. The God who death could not hold him down says, you come. You come. You. I have your name written and inscribed in the palm of my hand. You come. Come and dine at the master's table. Receive the bread and wine. Come and dine. Come and fellowship. So many times we hear that Jesus is knocking on the door of our hearts. If we would just but open up our hearts, then we can allow Christ to come in and dine with us. But truth be told, context be given, that is told to the church. The believer, the Christian, if you would but hear the voice of God, you are missing out on fellowship with God himself. You have sinned, yes, but you have a great God who's able to forgive. And if you're a believer, you've been forgiven. And if you're not a believer, you can be forgiven. There is hope for you today, because there's hope for the hopeless. There's help for the helpless. And guess what? It has nothing at all to do with you. And it has everything to do with God. That, my friends, is the gospel truth. That is true. The question is, what are you going to do about it? I was talking to an individual recently who said, you know, there's going to be a lot of Christians not in heaven. And I said, you know what, friends? Every Christian is making it to heaven. There's many people that claim the name of Christ and they have the badge that says Christian, and they're not truly Christians. Those people are not going to make it to heaven. But the true Christian are those who Christ has redeemed. Those who have placed their faith in Jesus Christ. They've repented of their sins. They've turned to that change of thinking. And they put their hope in the only one who can condemn them. Every one of those people are going to make it to heaven. And it's solely based upon the merits of Jesus Christ. I choose to get back up, to allow the Lord to wipe me off and clean me up, and to put me back in the race. You know, I have 5 kids, right? I have 3 boys, 2 girls. 3 thorns, 2 rose petals, right? And when they begin to walk, my wife would call me on the way to work and she would say, you know, Noah took 2 steps today. My response was never, well, how many times did he fall? Ridiculous. I was like, 2 steps? Are you kidding me? Really? Did you get it on camera? I want to see it. And so the focus, as it so often is for a lot of us, we focus on our failures. How we fail, and we forget that we're just failures. You know, even the culture said, man is forgiveness of individual sins that they fail to recognize that they're just a failure. I was talking with an atheist in the university one time, and he said, "Are you saying I'm not a good person?" And I said, "Absolutely. That's exactly what I'm saying." He says, "But I do plenty of good deeds." I said, "Probably to the fellow man and the people around you, I think perhaps that might be the case. But the Bible says whatever is not of faith is sin." So what may seem and look by appearance levels on a horizontal plane looks like a good thing is actually, if you're not a Christian, an evil act. And that's what the Bible says. Our righteous deeds are as evil acts, unrighteousness. The Hebrew is a very grotesque picture. It's actually a woman's menstrual rags. That's what your righteous deeds, your good works look like to God. And God says, "I can clean you up. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. And I can remove your sin as far as the east is from the west." Not the north from the south, right? You're familiar with that. God doesn't remove our sin up to the north. Because imagine, you start heading north, there's going to come a point you hit the north pole, and you keep going, you're heading out, start going south, right? Or you start heading south, eventually you get north. But if you start heading east, you will always head east. And if you go west, you will always go west. And he says, "I remove your sins from you as far as the east is from the west. They are enemies. They will not meet. They will not touch." What am I saying here today? As I wrap it up, I'm simply saying today, this life is almost over. It's almost through. You can live a victorious life, or you can live a condemned life. But if you're a believer, the Bible says there's no condemnation for you. And if you're not a believer, if you're not a Christian, you haven't surrendered, you have nothing but condemnation. Someone once said, if God is against you, it doesn't matter who is for you. And God is against you. If you're not a Christian here today, it's because you resist the God. But I'm telling you, in His mercy and grace and His unfathomable love, He offers you forgiveness. But you must act. You can't act. You have to act now. Or not promise tomorrow. Unless a man is born again, he's always one day. He was never born at all. You must come to God in faith, and that's the simple belief that God is telling the truth. You know, the Bible tells many different stories about different characters. One of those characters, this is the final thought before I let you go for the evening, is a man named Judas. Judas Iscariot was a man that Jesus himself poured into for approximately 3 years. All the while, he knew that Judas was going to betray him. At the very end, the final words that Jesus had to Judas was, "Why did you come, Judas? Friend, why did you come?" Were the words. Jesus called his betrayer, friend. And Judas is an interesting cat, as we say in Southern Cal. An interesting guy. Judas died thirsty next to the well of salvation. And I'm going to tell you, there is no greater tragedy than to be almost saved. Coming to church, singing the songs, teaching messages, yet living a life of hypocrisy. I'm not saying you don't fail. We're all going to fail. We're going to struggle with this struggle with that old man. I struggle with sin in totality. But I get back up in the race and I realize that Christianity is not about me, and my word for you is, listen, it's not about you either. Step out of your comfort zone. God specializes in using those who've been burnt and those who've burnt other people. But you have to come to Him on those terms. You must have repentance and faith. It's the way you came to Him, and that's the way you continue to come to Him. If you've never come to Him, that's how you come to Him. So what am I saying? Where do you go from here? It's simple. You need to have a conversation with God. It's called prayer. You just need to communicate. You go to God as you are, and you confess your sins before Him. And then you accept that forgiveness and you move forward. I'll tell you, there's how many churches, if you're a pastor of a church, can you raise your hand, a senior pastor of a church in here, you have one? Listen, if you're looking for a church, come and talk to this man. Come and talk to him. He has a church, and they have answers, and they have hope. And I believe that this is the church. I'm going to be speaking at your church on Sunday, tomorrow morning. And if you have nowhere to go, I'm telling you, you have a home and you have this family. And we understand that you have family issues. There's issues in the midst of the family. We don't pretend that everything's all okay and shake things beneath the rug. Come to a place where you're going to get honest truth. We're not going to put up a sin. We don't put up a sin in the camp. But you're welcome if you want to walk with God. If you don't know how, we'll show you how. Let's pray. And I have a final